Hi everybody, this is Morgan C, reporting for duty here on Transy Star Galactica. This week, Sama asks us to pick a country, and then fill out this kind of follow-up questions. I choose Canada because I live here, and I can speak with some sort of understanding about this country. Notice the great Canadian landscape, the Canadian dream, if you will. It's got motorboats, it's got various vehicles. I'll turn on the light, Evan, to illuminate. Oh my god, that's bright. You know, it's got a cabin in the lake, it's got motorboats, trucks, a little four-wheeler, lots of white people, middle class, love. You know, I escape into the wilderness for a while. That's how I kind of... imagine the broader vision of Canadian culture, almost an American culture. That's maybe something that is being pushed. I kind of feel like that's how Saskatchewan lays itself out. And that's maybe, that's a harsh stereotype. I don't really understand that. But at least I'm stereotyping my own country and not like another country and making weird gestures about that, I would think. You know, obviously, it's a really big country. There's lots of different things going on all over. Vancouver is very different than Saskatchewan. Saskatchewan is very different than Montreal, where I live now. Maritimes, totally different again. And then we have up north, like the three territories. It's a very different lifestyle up there, too. You know, there's a large population living, like, very close to the American border, and it disperses... up north, as far as you go further north. So, I mean, obviously, there's a lot of like colonialist attitudes going on in Canada. There's lots of white people, lots of European descendants. Lots of inequality amongst Aboriginal people compared to the white people who took over the land. It's kind of fucked up. What is trans culture like here? I don't think trans culture has maybe penetrated the mainstream. It hasn't, you know, there's not a lot of trans sports athletes. If that's like what the mainstream is in Canada, there's not a lot of trans politicians, if any. Not any, yeah, I don't know. What is the mainstream, or what is like culture? But I definitely noticed when I went to art school that there's definitely lots of queer artists. There's lots of trans artists. I feel like that's really positive, and I'm really happy about that. So as, you know, the culture that builds itself, it's happening. There's lots of filmmakers and musicians and visual artists and performance artists. And that's an exciting thing for me, I guess, because I'm into that area. But that, like, fine arts in Canada isn't really mainstream, I would say. It's definitely underappreciated on the whole, but maybe less, more appreciated in specifically Toronto, Montreal. Is that weird? I don't know. It's a very broad country. And that's a generalization. I feel uncomfortable making those generalizations, but I did it. Is it safe here? Is it safe in Canada to be trans? I feel really uncomfortable with this question, too. Recently, the Conservative government, which is the government and the party that's in power in Canada right now, and it's really shameful that we have that. I apologize to the rest of the world for what is happening right now. But one of the many weird shit they're pulling includes Bill C-31, which allows blanket statements like, is it safe to be trans here? to hold power over whether or not people can claim refugee status as LGBT people when they come to Canada. Like, for example, a couple years ago, a woman wanted to immigrate to Canada. She came to Montreal. They said Mexico is actually safe to be a trans person, sent her back, and recently she was murdered there in Mexico. Somehow the government has devised lists or reasons why a country is safe, and they fail to look at specifics of a person's life within that country. It's incredibly problematic, and it's really fucked up. So, I mean, saying that, I acknowledge that there are places in the planet that it is really, really dangerous to be trans and openly trans or openly queer. And I would say Canada is relatively safe. It's not without its problems and discriminations, both like all over the place. But I mean, it's hard because for me as a white, well-educated, we'll say, 28-year-old trans woman living in Montreal, I feel fairly safe. But I know in other people in Montreal who are trans are having really harsh living conditions and see a lot of discrimination constantly. Put me back in Saskatchewan, and suddenly I'm like kind of crapping my pants. Like it's really it scares me to think about living in other areas of the country, because I feel fairly safe in Montreal, but I'm like a fairly privileged person, so what the fuck do I know? Is it safe to be, I don't know. There's still lots of potential discrimination, assault, sexual violence, dehumanization. There's lots of shit that goes on in Canada that can be improved, but I don't know. It has a very low rate of percentage of trans people who are killed, which is something, I guess, but that's not much. What does it feel like to learn about this country and its trans people? I feel like learning about trans people makes me really happy, usually. Like it's satisfying to know more and more about other trans people, that they exist and all that. But to learn about this country is a task, like a journey into disillusionment, more or less, because it just keeps getting scarier and scarier. We have a lot of problems with that stem completely from the conservative government. Like they are making environmental standards just disappear in favor of, you know, doing whatever corporations want us to do. They're taking away clean water. They're taking, like, adding a lot of environmental pollution. They're going to be doing a lot of mining and drilling for oil and doing the tar sands bullshit, spreading that around. They take more and more rights from Aboriginal people every day, and they fail to acknowledge that there's anything wrong with that. There's a really awesome movement going on right now, which I don't know if it's being covered much abroad or in America, called Idle No More, where it's an Aboriginal rights movement and a human rights movement, too, I guess you could say, to defend their rights against what's happening here. So I'm hope that goes the best it can. You know, the country is really scary in a lot of different ways. Another reason I feel like it gets scarier for trans people is that there's been HIV criminalization more recently. Like, there's been a trial where a man was convicted of assault because he had sex with another person. And he had told the other person that he had HIV, and then when it was passed to this new person, they pressed charges and claimed that he never disclosed this. Now he's been arrested. And the criminalization of HIV is super fucked up and, has the power to affect trans people, trans trans women have the highest rate of prevalence, I guess, of HIV infections more than any other group, which is like a kind of a fact that kind of slips through a lot of people's radar, I guess, under the radar. So that's a bit scary. I would hate to have my sexuality criminalized, you know? And so that's just like a worst case scenario for me, to end up going to prison for having sex and then end up probably in a men's prison. Because, you know, I'm actually a man. Because of my genitals, or whatever. Okay, so what else? There's a couple positive things, you know, universal healthcare, which is not totally the best program, but I mean it's probably better than fucking going bankrupt every time you get sick or you know, if one of your family members has an illness that needs to be treated. But that's like one cool example of healthcare working for trans people is in Quebec. You can actually get SRS covered by the government. You have to go jump through hoops and shit. You have to see psychologists and see, you know, pay them money for a while. But you can get your SRS surgery, both phalloplasty and vaginoplasties, covered by the government, which is cool. I mean, personally, I don't really care because I like my genitals, but there's a little bit of me that's like bargain hunter. Like, well, if I could get it for free, maybe I should consider that. But whatever, it's not really free. You still have to pay a couple hundred dollars for psychological testings and shit, but not nearly as much as you would otherwise. Oh yeah, okay, so one more thing. Another positive thing about Canada is that recently there was a court case in Ontario where a trans woman won the right to have her sex designation changed without having to have any sort of surgical procedures on the genitalia, which is the commonly accepted Canadian way to make sure that you are now truly a transsexual woman or whatever, or man. So that's cool. Ontario, yeah, I would... anyone born in Ontario can change their sex, you know, whatever. There's still procedures you have to go through, but not surgical ones, which is cool for me, because that's what I'm down with. Hopefully, as far as I understand, like, other provinces could follow this. Saskatchewan might follow this, where I was born. Quebec has a different sort of civil code based off of France. Codes? I don't really understand it. But the rest of the country, there's a good chance that they'll follow this precedent-setting court case. But I'm not sure if that's true. Just hopeful. Just being hopeful. Hoping for a better tomorrow here in Canada. I really wish the current conservative government wasn't in power. But, yeah. We'll see. We'll see how it happens in the future. Good luck, world. That's all I have to say. Report is done. Dream is over. Okay. Bye.